This question was asked in the 2024 August KUHS examination as an MCQ. The ovum is surrounded by a non-cellular layer known as the corona radiata, theca folliculi, zona pellucida, or cumulus oophorus. Now here the most important word that you have to focus is the word non-cellular. The answer for this question is zona pellucida. Now, what is zona pellucida? You need to know what is the oocyte cumulus complex or the cumulus oocyte complex. This is a structure that is released in an ovulation. So let us have a look at that once more. What you see here is an oocyte, and the membrane, the plasma membrane of that oocyte cell is known as the vitelline membrane. Now, around this vitelline membrane, you have a non-cellular layer shown by this red color, and that is known as the zona pellucida. Zona pellucida, the word means a transparent zone. Pellucida means transparent, and zona means zone. Okay, that is zona pellucida. So it is a non-cellular layer, it is transparent, and it is seen around the oocyte. And around the zona pellucida, you have a cellular layer. A lot of cells are there, and that is called as the corona radiata. Corona radiata is actually the same as the cumulus oophorus that you saw in the graphene follicle. You can refer to the graphene follicle video to understand more details about this structure. So this corona radiata cells are actually the follicular cells which is occupying the cumulus oophorus. So some authors also call this as the cumulus oophorus instead of corona radiata. So from inside to outside, in order, the structures are vitelline membrane, zona pellucida, and corona radiata. This order is very important because from the outside, a sperm will have to penetrate these three layers. The corona radiata first, then the zona pellucida, and then the vitelline membrane in order to complete the fertilization. These are the three phases of fertilization. So these layers are very important. And of this, zona pellucida is the transparent non-cellular layer. Now let us have a look at a scanning electron microscope view of the zona pellucida. You can see the oocyte here. This is the oocyte. Okay, that is, I've drawn through the diameter of the oocyte. So this will be the vitelline membrane or the cell membrane of the oocyte. Here you are seeing the zona pellucida around it. Okay, this structure is the zona pellucida. And you can also see that underneath the zona pellucida and outside the vitelline membrane, there is a space. Okay, there is a space that you are seeing here. That space is called the perivitelline space. After penetrating the zona pellucida, the head of the oocyte, head of the sperm can remain in the perivitelline space, and then it merges with the vitelline membrane. So that is the perivitelline space, and this is the zona pellucida. Now, even in the later phase, that means even after fertilization, you can see the presence of the zona pellucida in the initial cleavage divisions. This is the cleavage divisions. The cells are multiplying, but still you can see the presence of the zona pellucida over there. The transparent layer around the oocyte. Okay, thank you.